welcome to Manchester, and we're live here at the Furs, a rather interesting name for Fallowfields playing fields, as also known as at here at Manchester University. And we've got an atmosphere here for this match for sure. We've got a big crowd here. They're queuing to get into the stands. It's England, Australia, and those are people on the camera. If we can, as obviously people all over our platform, if we just pull out, we can just see that they're filling up nicely over there. And it's England versus Australia here on our main pitch. Our cameraman can just pull out a little bit. We've even got Desmond Lynham in the crowd. What's he doing there? For those of you watching this internationally, he's a fairly famous sports presenter here in the UK. And well, the teams are getting ready. England have just taken the pitch. It's a real big game atmosphere here. We've just seen Japan beating Germany by 15-9. And well, there's the England team. They've just arrived. A little bit late, but the Aussies have been out warming up. They're actually out this morning having a bit of a drill. They had the tough taste of defeat at the hands of the USA last night. And their coach was giving them a pretty hard time. We had our mics pitch side and could hear he was getting very emotive about particular moves. But I think we're getting ready for the national anthems here.
Now we invite you to join us as we honor Team Australia with the Australian national anthem.
Both teams quite fired up here, and the national anthem's going as expected. And now we're going to get the announcement of the squads. We're still having a bit of a problem with the PA system here. Those that water really did get into the system, So we're still getting a bit of a crackle on the line, but we'll try and play as much as we can. And apologies for the crackle, but let's listen in.
Welcome to the stadium pitch here at the University of Manchester Armitage Centre and day three of the 2010. The bench manager
for here we go.
Don Balch from the United States.
A really big match here.
From Japan, Mr. Keiichi.
It's going to be a tight one. It's going to be really interesting to see. And both teams have got something to really say here. Both teams really do have something to try and make up on this particular occasion. And away we go here in the first period, and Australia straight away coming in on the attack. And very pleased to say Neil Golding is with me, who's the press officer here at the World Championships. And he knows a lot of the England setup. He's also got a million and one other jobs to do. And this is very, very tense indeed. Oh, a shot in from Australia, and Ben McAllister makes a very smart save indeed, but there's a miss. Oh, mistake there from the English defenseman. The English number 13 made a real hash of that. Just a simple pass from McAllister.
That was Alex
Neil, Dave. It's good to have you on board. Welcome.
Hi, Adrian. How are you doing?
Very well, thank you, and great to have you on board. It's a big match, and it's good to have a big person in here, Mr. Pressman himself, looking after everybody, looking after the world's press. You've been pretty worked hard with Iroquois as well over the last few days, and now we're on to the lacrosse. What's your thoughts about this match?
It's a great match. I think many people will be surprised that Australia were beaten so convincingly by the USA. I thought maybe it'd be a much closer game. But so they've got something to prove, and England, of course, will be full of confidence, beating Germany 12-3, having literally 2.5 hours to prepare for the match, having originally been an exhibition match. So yeah, great match, and we've built it up in the press today as a match of the Ashes. So hopefully this is the start of things before the cricket in the summer.
Well, here we go, and this is the view from behind the goal. Ben McAllister, who likes to have an odd dribble or two.
We saw this in the opening match. Big Mac's not afraid to run down the centre of the pitch. Sam Russell on the ball there for England. Let's see if England can move the ball quickly.
Neil,
it's back to Russell.
You saw the last match. There's a question that really came up on the chat room, and there was a lot of discussion about England weren't very good against Germany, but we just saw Germany actually scare Japan quite badly in that last match. So I think we were all did Germany a bit of a disservice, and England actually did well to actually run out such comfortable winners against Germany in that match.
I think so. I think England played quite well defensively. The D was very tight. Big Mac in net. Ben McAllister was solid, made 16 shots during the match. Athletic defence, tried to rush things, but Dave Old, the head coach, got them in at second half and said, play our own game. And it worked. And they ran away with the second half, dominated it. And it gave Dave and the rest of the coaches the chance to blood a few players at the end. So yeah, good start. And probably a professional performance is what you'd call it.
Well, this is a really big match here. If it all goes to seedings, these two teams will go to a semi-final against USA or Canada, and both of them look incredibly strong. So you could say that there's no potential benefit in getting victory here now, but of course it does all go well for a potential third, fourth place playoff. These two could be playing exactly in a week's
great
time.
Great save from Big McAllister there, Ben, in net. No, I think you're right, Adrian. But if you speak to the England boys, and I think if you speak to the Aussie boys, this is a psychological boost, and they'll want to win this one. It's a big game for both teams, and whoever wins here will have plenty of confidence if they do meet for that semi-final place.
Yeah.
And I think you can tell from the open, it's quite a cautious opening. Both teams sort of checking each other out, and I'm sure both teams will hot up as we get on.
Oh,
there's your opening goal. Low shot, beat McAllister, he's near post.
Well, let's have a look at this one again. And, well, what happened here, Neil? What do you think? Let's have a quick look.
England defence stood off.
Oh, go again, 1 second. Here we go.
Powerful shot, low shot, bottom left-hand corner. Trying to see the number. We can't see the number, unfortunately. It's quite the glare.
There's a massive glare out there. Considering that a few hours ago it was getting towards almost night time. It was so dark. Now it's turned into quite a nice day.
Yeah, you wouldn't recognise it. And the great thing is you can see the crowd there, Adrian. We've got a full house today. Yeah. Super Saturday. We've got some great games. USA and Canada tonight. Everyone's tipping us the final this year. But great to see people out. And 2-3 hours ago, it was absolutely bucketed bound. So, yeah, great to see. And hopefully this crowd can get behind England, no bias, and cheer them on to a good victory here.
Absolutely. We're totally neutral here, you know. But that's a good start for Australia. And he was a little bit too open, really. Had a good swing at that shot to get some power behind it. And Australia, at the moment, England just can't get hold of a ball. They've made a couple of mistakes. I just wonder whether there's a bit of nerves. You know, these guys want to play in front of such a big home crowd.
Great save, Ben McAllister there.
Like, when was the last time they've played in such a big crowd? There's 5,000 in that stand.
They've not played in front of a crowd as big as for a while. Playing in front of a decent crowd when they won the European Championships a couple of years back. And they've been to America on a tour, playing in front of university side, some really top ones. But yeah, this is probably the biggest crowd England have played in front of for a while. Great occasion for both sides, really. And obviously always a great rivalry between Australia and England.
Absolutely. Well, I hope I didn't upset any Australians. I know they watched the match last night on DVD, and I did make reference to USA running up a cricket score. I like those sort of puns, you know, a bit humorous, really. And I hope I didn't wind the Australians up any further.
It's Matt Bagley feeding the ball out left. Nick Watson at the back of the cage. England again being patient. No, I don't think you wound any more page, and I think there'll be plenty of rivalry for this game. England, oh, chance just behind the back.
There were some very sullen Australian faces last night, and they were hit it quite late as well. The Americans cleared them and went straight away, and they disappeared into the night, but the Australians were hanging around the venue, and there wasn't a smile amongst them. They were very unhappy indeed, having lost to the United States by only 3 goals 4 years ago. Oh, that's
bad pass there. That was Watson. Watson there to Bagley. It was too high for him, and England gave up possession.
Oh, it's a chance.
In. That was a chance for Matt Garnsworthy.
It's a big chance.
Although, yeah, that's Ryan's brother. Just checking that wasn't Ryan. Ryan used to play for Timperley in the North of England League here, so a lot of these England boys would be familiar with him. He scored a goal for Australia in their defeat to the USA last night. Yeah, so early on it's Australia possession, although they've only got the one goal. Quite a slow start.
The chat, unfortunately, the scoreboard electronics haven't improved, so we're still on we've got no real idea of the time. Do apologize for that. Hopefully we'll get that sorted out very soon. We did have a most amazing downpour just a few hours ago, and if you watched yesterday, you'd have seen that we do have it working. It isn't just a blank space, but at the moment it's not there.
Very, very patient by Australia this. Just trying to work an opening, but the England defence is staying pretty firm at the moment. Great block again there.
Of course, it's early on here, Neil, and I'll just answer a question in the chat. Neil Golding with me, who's a press officer here at the World Championships, and looks after all the world and international press and the news releases. Produces a fantastic newsletter every day as well for everybody to read. And you know, it's got to be said, these two, you know, we've got two squads here who are fully adrenalised for this match. If Australia doesn't get you going enough, and it does take a while. We've seen in Lacrosse sometimes it can take a couple of periods for a bit of tiredness to set in and for a team to sort of assert their authority, just as we saw in the last match where Japan were down at half time 8-6, actually ran out 15-9 in the end.
Yeah, I think so. Second goal. That's number 15 for Australia.
Well, let's have a look at this on the replay. Oh, what an acute angle that was.
I think that was James Watson Galbraith, actually number 16. Left-handed shot.
Yeah, yeah, let's have a look at that. We didn't get it from the other camera. But 2-0 to Australia. What a start for the Aussies.
It's an important face-off now. England will want to hit back straight away.
What a great start.
This is going to be a tester for England now, in front of the home fans here, see if they can respond. They showed against Germany that they have plenty of confidence when they get on a roll. Okay, so England on the ball, just changing a bit of personnel here. You've got Mark Reynolds on the ball here. He changes. Sam Russell wide. Fake. There it is. Thomas Gosney on the ball.
Neil, do you think Ben McAllister will be a little disappointed having conceded a goal from such a narrow angle?
I don't think so. I think it was a powerful shot. It's always hard for the low shots. Ben's had a great tournament so far. And I'm told by Dave Elwood, the head coach, that Nick Anderton's been pushing really hard, but Ben's to the managed to keep himself in, and it was proven in the Germany game. There's a chance for England. Oh! Hit the post, right-hand post, great shot. And the keeper's not the goal's off its markings.
Are we going to have a no, we don't have a stoppage in play for this, do we? They're carrying on, I think.
No flag down, no man up, just long ball up, quick break there, fast break from Australia. It's nice to see the sun out for a change. We've been here, many of us, since the start of the week when there were festival games, primary school games, secondary school games. Lots of youngsters playing pop lacrosse, hopefully future stars. And a lot of whom will be back in the crowd to watch the match today.
Well, Australia have had a fantastic start here. About 5 minutes gone. If you can hear whistles and things, there is another match going on behind, so don't worry that you think there's officials calling things. There's another match going on pitch number two right now, which is Argentina and Netherlands.
Yeah, and that is 27-3, and we'll let you know to which team. So one team's winning quite convincingly.
Oh, it's another goal!
Australia 3-0.
Australia are romping this. Unbelievable. Well, let's have a look at the replay. We won't get a replay from that camera. Let's just try one. Here we go. Here's the shot. And oh, straight into the top left corner.
Yeah, Australia started really well here. England needs to just regroup here and get some possession. It's all been Australia this opening quarter.
Yeah.
Yeah, timeout here called, probably rightly as well, because England have just started a little bit slow out the blocks. And all credit to Australia, they've taken the initiative and held onto the ball. Deserve their lead.
Well, what a tremendous start for Australia. And well, I'm keeping an eye on the chat room. And if you've got any questions for myself or Neil, very happy to take them. I've heard everything under the sun about criticising commentators, so you can leave that one alone. There's quite a few Aussie supporters out there, certainly enjoying things. And I don't know what time. Anybody in Australia in the chat room? And it must be some ridiculous time in the middle of the night over there. But I'm sure there's a few family and friends who are watching this and really enjoying what they're seeing. A couple of calls for Come On England, and feeling that England might still win this, but 3-0 down at the moment. They're not actually getting the possession of the ball in their attacks.
Yeah.
I think England have had, they had one good shot on target which hit the post, and the goal moved.
That's the only chance they've had.
Yeah.
It's important. Tom Gallen, it's his first game and he's had food poisoning and he's won the face-off, which is important. England will look here. Oh, and straight away they give the ball away. Shame, really. Great win from the face-off for them. But Jack Wozniak gave the ball away and Australia possession again.
Yeah.
So they've wasted a chance there, having won that face-off.
Well, the match has finished over on pitch two and the final score was 29-3, so they got a couple more goals in the last minute. And here's a move.
Just wide of the left-hand post. Again, England looked quite exposed there, didn't close down. And maybe nearly caught by a fast break again. I think England just need to get hold of the ball here, calm things down and get their first goal, and I think the confidence can flow from there if they do. But it's all Australia at the moment. There's a ball. Yeah, flag down. Can England make use of this advantage? This is England's chance. 3-0 down. Opportunity here to try and grab a goal back. I think the start has silenced the crowd a little bit as well. I think they expected England maybe to start a bit brighter. So we could do with a goal there. See if England can get on target.
Well, we're not... we haven't reached do or die time yet for England, but you really feel that for their confidence, it's very important that they try and get a goal on the board fairly quickly.
Yeah, I'd agree, Adrian. I think they were a bit quicker and slicker with the passing the other evening. There's a chance. There we go. Great goal, England. It's Adrian Bennett who scored the other evening. AD Bennett scored 3 the other evening. Nice little feed inside. Shot top right-hand corner. Too good for the Aussie goalkeeper. And that's just what England needed. 3-1. Made use of that opportunity. That'll give them plenty of confidence.
Well, there's the replays.
Great feed in there from Tom Gosney.
Here it is.
Great finish, AD Bennett. Good lacrosse, England.
Great replays there, and England will be very happy indeed to have got their first goal on the board. The pressure was starting to mount, and I think the crowd loved it as well. The crowd sort of started waking up. There's a fair little Aussie contingent out there. It's not 100% England.
Oh, there's quite a few Aussie fans in, and they'll be up for this one. I went out to the Women's World Games in Annapolis 5 years back, and they had their Skippy the Kangaroo, the inflatable kangaroo. I'm not seeing what the men's mascot is, but yeah, there's plenty of Aussie fans in the crowd, and there's always a good rivalry between the two nations, so yeah, it just makes for an interesting bit of extra spice, Adrian.
Absolutely. This is going to be interesting. And England's starting to put a little whiz of chance here.
No, that's going to be easy for Sam Williams, the Aussie goalkeeper.
Yeah. Well, the Aussies had a very tough time last night. They had the last match against the United States, and they were heavily down very early on. They really never had a chance. And, well, things really turned around here. 3-0 up very early on.
You'd think it'd be slightly different as well, because the Aussies have not had much rest. England had a nice day off yesterday. Aussies finished late, 8 late last night, and have had to come on again this afternoon, so you would think in theory England be a little bit fresher, but
yeah.
Both teams would be well drilled for this this match, and like you said, Adrian, they've both got a point to prove.
Yeah. Here's a chance. Number 12, and he's way over.
It's a high shot there from Adam Sear. It was always going over, but it had plenty of legs on it.
I think our cameraman was a little bit nervous there. He was heading towards him behind the goal. Just watch this. Here he goes.
Yeah, it's just a high shot from Adam Sear here. Ben McAllister.
Back to the line.
Had that covered. Another chance. Great save, McAllister there. That was from Ryan Garnes with it. As I mentioned before, Ryan used to play for Timpley, was the local development officer, a coach. He used to go into schools here. So a lot of the England boys will know him, and a couple of lads from Timpley who have played with him know how good a player he is.
Here's McAllister on one of his runs. And he suddenly knew, Australia have got this one planned. Do you think they saw his first match where he did that?
I think so, but England have got this planned and they've got a break here. That's well saved. Good save there by Sam Williams, the Aussie goalkeeper.
And another quick counter-attack now from Australia.
I think we're seeing now the game's opening up after a cautious start by both. Shot wide there, the right-hand post. Yeah, both teams playing quite open lacrosse now.
Well, it's really starting to get itself going, and that England flag blows around. We've got flags all over the place here.
It's just nice to see the sun instead of the rain here, isn't it?
Yes, I think some of the internationals understanding why us Brits always complain about the weather. You never know what you're going to get.
Gareth Allen feed out. Again, Australia being quite patient. Back to Sam Bullock. Sam Bullock lining up. Wide of the left-hand post.
Look at this one. How close is this? Not that close, really.
Again, it's all Australia there. Australia holding on to the possession really well, feeding the ball, being patient around the cage. Great D from England. Picked up.
Oh, good speed.
It's Williamson. Great ball. Oh.
There's a whistle going there. And all that whistles was that offside. Maybe England got a bit excitable there. And whistles are going again. The match next door is finished, so the only whistles you are going to hear now are going to be from this pitch.
It's a timeout.
Okay, timeout. So 3-1.
I think you'd have to say in the balance, Australia are much better side. They've been patient, control the possession. But that goal will do England the world of good. Made use of the man-up opportunity. Give a good crowd something to shout about.
We're understanding that the players are now heading to their homes and awaiting word with regards to the latest proposal they have submitted to the British Council in regards to their travel documents. We're awaiting further confirmation.
So time out here for England, and what do you think he's saying here? He's got his arms outstretched, he seems to be being quite animated.
That's Dave Elwood, the head coach. He's probably just saying, we've got to hold on to the ball, be patient, not rush things, and play our own game, because England have got their own strategies. In fact, the England boys, they all had clipboards last night. It was quite a funny picture. They all had to do research on the players they were playing against today, although they'll do team meetings, but they're individuals who they're coming up against. Yeah. And they watched the US game late last night and analysed all the players. So, yeah, England have taken these matches very seriously, and Tom Gallen on the face now will know what he's up against. He'll be up against Aaron Nicholas here, the Williamstown player. Yeah, just important here that England can get hold of the face-off, try and win the ball. And get a bit of a foothold in this match. Yeah, Gallen, again, Aussie ball. Now England ball.
There's a fairly big match coming up next after this as well, which I know this big crowd are all going to stay to watch. It's the USA versus Canada, the number one and two teams in the world. Question is, nobody's really sure who's one and who's two at the moment.
No, it's hard to know, but both USA and Canada started really impressively. Obviously USA beat Australia 21-5.